Racing to the 2023 Belmont Stakes, the granddaddy of them all, the post positions have been drawn for the test of the champion. We're going to take a look at the final works, top contenders, exacta plays, and my pick for the Belmont Stakes, along with a long shot pick. Let's get to it. The Belmont Stakes 2023, a 9-horse field, including the juvenile champion Forte. He drew a good post position. He's one of two Todd Pletcher trained horses. Tapit, Trice at 3-1. Forte, the morning line favorite at 5-2. We've got the Preakness Stakes winner, National Treasure. He is 5-1. Brad Cox sends out three runners in this year's Belmont Stakes. We've got Tapit Shoes out of the one hole. He ran second in his most recent race. He's a half to Cyberknife, who also ran in some big races last year as a three-year-old. You've got Archangelo, the Peter Pan Stakes winner. Il Miracolo, a recent winner at Gulfstream Park, ready to take on the big boys. He's got a couple of lifetime wins on the front end. Angel of Empire, the Arkansas Derby winner, and he also won the Risen Star Stakes at the fairgrounds. Red Route 1 goes for trainer Steve Asmussen. Red Route 1, sired by Gunrunner, goes for Winchell Thoroughbreds. He won the Bathhouse Stakes. He ran evenly in the Preakness Stakes. He had some depth to this field. And you've got Hit Show, the Wither Stakes winner, already a winner in New York earlier this year. He also won at Oaklawn Park and at Keeneland, a competitive field of 9 for the Belmont Stakes. Of course, final workouts were over the last couple of days. Forte, let's take a look at him. He went 5 furlongs. I like this workout. He's in company. He's nothing really flashy here, but I like the long gallop out. He galloped out an extra couple of furlongs for Forte, his final workout on Saturday. Meanwhile, it was National Treasure getting the 5 furlongs. A nice workout here. The ears are forward. He's getting through the big Belmont wide sweeping turns, crosses the finish line. Again, a 7 furlong gallop out for National Treasure. Those are the final workouts of some of the main contenders. Now, the Belmont pace this year, I'm expecting a little bit of a slow pace. We did have a slow pace in the Preakness Stakes with really only one speed horse in National Treasure. This time around, we've got National Treasure and Il Miracolo that could take the pace. Remember, the Kentucky Derby, we had a fast pace, and we had a come-from-behind runner at 17-1 in Mage, coming off the pace in the Kentucky Derby. So I think the Belmont pace is going to be a little bit slower. We've got a couple of horses that can contest it, but it should allow the pack to kind of group up, and we definitely have 5 or 6 contenders here. And Archangelo, he's won back-to-back races. He won a Gulfstream Park maiden. Here he is the last time around, winning the Peter Pan stretch-long duel against Bishop's Bay. And he can come from a little off the pace. He's by Arrogate, has a solid pedigree, is stretching out for the first time to 1.5 miles is Archangelo. Now, Forte was scratched on the Kentucky Derby. He's an off-the-pace runner in the Fountain of Youth. 7 starts, 6 wins. Here he is as a 2-year-old against Loggins at Keeneland, running a nice race in the Grade 1 Breeders' Futurity. He's got 4 Grade 1 races lifetime. Forte, the morning line favorite at 5-2 for the Belmont Stakes. Angel of Empire, the Arkansas Derby winner. He was 3rd in the Kentucky Derby. Here he is pulling away in the Arkansas Derby. He came from behind. He's a mid-pack runner. He'll be wearing those blue silks with the big white star. Angel of Empire, definitely a chance here to be one of the top 4 favorites in the Belmont Stakes. Tapit Trice, the key thing here, he breaks last in every race. He's got long, powerful strides. Here he is breaking last in the Tampa Bay Derby, but he ended up passing them all, winning the Tampa Bay Derby from last to first. He's by Tapit, who has sired 4 Belmont Stakes winners. Todd Pletcher with 4 Belmont Stakes winners. Of course, Tapit go wearing the pink silks of Mandy Pope. Tapit Trice going to be coming from behind in this pack of 9 horses. You've got Hit Show. Hit Show is a presser, meaning he comes a little off the pace. In the Withers, he competed on a deep track in Belmont. He can sit mid-pack, make his move. He was up close to the pace in the Kentucky Derby, but Hit Show definitely a chance here to make his move going into the turn. And a lot of times that winning move in the Belmont is made at the top of the stretch with a little over a quarter of a mile to go. Hit Show goes as one of three horses for trainer Brad Cox. You've got National Treasure, Blinkers for the Preakness. I like his most recent workout, a strong workout, solo workout. Of course, he put Blinkers on for that Preakness, a stretch duel winning over Blazing Sevens. He's got speed. He's fresh. Remember, he had to scratch out of the San Felipe with a foot injury, then ran an even fourth, galloping out strong in the San Anita Derby. National Treasure survived that stretch duel in the Preakness. He fits 5-1 morning line odds for National Treasure for trainer Bob Baffert. Red Route 1 is a deep closer, evenly in the Preakness, had his final workout on Monday. He's going to be a little bit of a long shot here. You know, he's had a long campaign. He's competed in all these stakes races, but he has had a lot of starts, and I'm not sure he's really improving. Il Miracolo adds some speed to the race. Let's take a look at the Beyer speed figures, which basically shows how each of the horses finished up their race from a final standpoint. But remember, these races were all earned in shorter efforts. The Belmont Stakes will be the farthest that any of these horses have ever ran in their lifetime. They're gonna go 12 furlongs, a mile and a half. Angel of Empire with a 104 in the Kentucky Derby. Tapit Trice with a 99 in the Bluegrass. Forte with a 98 in the Fountain of Youth. You had Hit Show with a 98 in the Kentucky Derby, National Treasure with a 98 in the Preakness, and Arcangelo a 97. A very contentious, from the speed figure standpoint, 5-6 horses. Let's take a look at the pace of the race. At the 4-furlong mark, I see National Treasure and Il Miracolo battling on that front end. Your pressers are going to be Hit Show and Arcangelo. And then the mid-pack, you've got Tapit Shoes, you've got Angel of Empire, you got Forte, and really, Tapit Trice and Red Route 1, they're going to be last early at that 4-furlong mark. Now, at the 6-furlong mark, I think National Treasure takes the lead. He's got the most natural speed. He's got blinkers. He's coming off a nice win and a good workout. I think the three horses here highlighted in green, that's where they're going to start to make their move. Hit Show, Angel of Empire, and Tapit Trice. Forte, I think, going to wait a little bit longer. He's probably going to wait to the mile marker of this race to make his move. So National Treasure, how far along can he take them on the lead? My top selection, I think you can make the case here for any one of these four or five contenders. I'm going to be looking to upset the favorite here. Forte, definitely a strong chance. National Treasure, a big workout. Angel of Empire, a nice Kentucky Derby effort. But I'm going to be going with Tapit Trice. I think he's going to like the distance. I like his recent workouts. I think he can be close to the slower pace, get to the outside, and then try to mow him down in the lane. He's been working out forwardly. Todd Pletcher does a great job getting these horses ready for the mile and a half. They tend to show more speed when his horses are successful. I'm going to be going in exactas over National Treasure, Angel of Empire, and Arcangelo for my top selection, Tapit Trice. Long shot pick, if you want to take a 10-1 shot or higher, that's going to be Arcangelo. Play him in exactas over Tapit Trice and Angel of Empire if you want a little bit of a long shot play. Forte, a very solid horse. Nothing wrong with Angel of Empire. Remember, we've been providing all this information for you to make your Belmont Stakes picks. Take a look at who I've got. Take a look at who you like. Pick a name, pick a number. It's always fun to pick the winner of the Belmont Stakes. This time around, we've got 5 or 6 strong contenders. Don't forget, Tuesday night, 7 o'clock Central, 8 o'clock Eastern, we're going to do a handicapping show on the Belmont Stakes, go over all the horses, take your questions and comments on the Belmont Stakes, look at that pace. We've also got a preview of the Elite 8 up, and also a horse-by-horse analysis up on the channel. Remember, it's your turn now. Smash that like button. Who do you like to win the Belmont Stakes, the test of the champion? Leave a comment. Let's get your picks and start the discussion on the Belmont Stakes. And remember, as Dwayne Lucas always says, people have opinions, horses have the facts.